Unit number 24, Environmental Science. The previous class we have studied water cycle, nitrogen cycle. Today we are going to study carbon cycle. How the carbon move one stage to another stage. So this is the things we are going to study now. So it is a very clear pictures how that carbon it's move one stage to another stage. So when you take here, carbon is released into the atmosphere where fossil fuel are burned. So we are using the fossil fuel. So what are the fossil fuel? Petrol, diesel, kerosene. So these are we call as a fossil fuel. So while we are using to run vehicles, so it will release the carbon dioxide. So the carbon dioxide, the carbon is there. So it is released to the atmosphere. So carbon is released into the atmosphere during respirations. So all the animals and all the living organism, during the respiration time, it will release the carbon dioxide. So the carbon dioxide have carbon. So carbon deposit in the atmosphere. So what about this? So it eat the plants. So the plants contain the carbon. So it move to the animals. So during the respirations, so it will deposit in atmosphere. So carbon dioxide in the atmosphere used in photosynthesis to produce carbohydrate. The plants use that carbon dioxide for the photosynthesis process. So the carbon is intake during the photosynthesis. After that decaying, the plants produce carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. So carbon dioxide in the fossil fuel, coal and oil. Carbon dioxide in the decay material and wastes. So this is the cycle. So it's a good explanations to understand about the carbon cycle. Carbon cycle, what do you mean by carbon cycle? Carbon occurs in various form of on earth. Not only it's a one form, it's a various form. Diamond, charcoal, graphites are element formation of carbon. So this maybe is a carbon in the form of charcoal, diamond or graphite. So this is the form. So the carbon is formed in various on the earth. The atmospheric carbon dioxide enter into the plants during the photosynthesis. So already told that the atmospheric carbon dioxide enter into the plants through the process of photosynthesis to form carbohydrate. So look at that. So the sunlight is there, carbon dioxide is available in the atmosphere. So it is a intake with the help of the water and three of them. So it will produce the carbohydrate. The oxygen is released and sugar also formed. So this is the another diagram, the same things. Carbon dioxide intake by the plants. So oxygen release. So oxygen release during the photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide intake during the photosynthesis. So this is the one. The atmospheric carbon dioxide enter into the plants through the process of photosynthesis to form carbohydrate. So this is the things easily we know that from plants it pass on the herbivorous and carnivorous. So it not only is stopped from the plants, so the carbon is moved to the herbivorous. What do you mean by the herbivorous? Herbivorous is nothing, only we eat the plants only. So look at this, the food chain. So this is the plants. The plants eat the grasshopper. So the grasshopper we call is a herbivorous. Suppose we can take is a cow. So here the carbon is present.
while that grasshopper eat the plant, so the carbon is moved to the herbivorous. After the herbivorous, so it moved to the carnivorous. So where is the carnivorous? So the grasshopper eat by frog. So the carbon which is present the grasshopper, it moved to the next stage. So after that it moved to the terrestrial territory consumer, and it goes to the next stage. So at last it go to the decompositions. So very simple things, the plants pass the carbon to herbivorous and carnivorous. So during the respirations, plants and animals release carbon into atmosphere in the form of carbon dioxide. So we all know that is during the photosynthesis, the carbon is intake. During the respiration time, the carbon dioxide released. Carbon dioxide is also returned to the atmosphere through decomposition of the dead organic matter. So after the animals or human or plants, so if they go for a decomposition, so the automatically the carbon dioxide release from that. So it will deposit into the atmosphere. So look at this. Carbon dioxide is also returned to the atmosphere through decomposition of dead organic matter. Not only that, burning fossil fuel and volcanic activities. So this is the very simple things. The carbon, it's deposit into the atmosphere while burning of the fossil fuel or volcanic activities and decomposition of the dead organic matter. So this is the another stage. So the carbon is not stable in one stage, so it will move to the another stage. It become like a cycle. Look at this. So the eagle, after that it decomposition is take over after the death of the eagle. So once again it move or it absorb by the plants, the organic matter which is present in the soil after the decomposition of the eagle. So where it get the carbon from? Snake. So where it get? Frog. The carbon it get from the frog. The frog gets the carbon from grasshopper. The grasshopper gets the carbon from plants. So this is the things, it's a cycle of the carbon. Animal respirations and fossil fuel while we are burning. So this is the one. And plants respirations. So during the plant respiration, it is opposite of the photosynthesis. Here carbon dioxide intake, here oxygen intake, here oxygen release, here carbon dioxide release. So this is the difference between the photosynthesis and respirations. And root respirations, oceans, factory emissions. So while they are using that coal, what will happen? It will release the carbon in the form of the carbon dioxide. So little information about the carbon cycle. Then another one. So here the carbon dioxide, it comes as the smoke. Human impacts on carbon cycle. So what are the way they will disturb or the human disturb the carbon cycle? So it is the nature process. Carbon cycle is a nature process. It move one stage to another stage, then another stage to another stage. For example, it move from atmosphere to plants. The carbon move from plants to herbivorous. The carbon moves herbivorous to omnivorous. the carbon moves carnivorous to decomposition. After the decompositions, it is settled down or deposited in the soil. Once again, the plants absorb the carbon. So this is the cycle of that. So more carbon moves into the atmosphere during the burning of fossil fuel and deforestations. So what happens? So burning of the fossil fuel, coal and petroleum, diesel, whatever may be, while we are burning, so the amount may be increase. If the carbon dioxide amount will be increased in the atmosphere, means so we should have the enough trees. We only come to know that during the photosynthesis, the tree use the carbon dioxide, or the plants use the carbon dioxide, it will convert or it will release the oxygen. So it will reduce the amount of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So it is the mutual as well as healthy movements, one stage to another stage. But while we are cutting the trees or deforestations, what will happen? There is no enough plants, or there is no enough trees which carried or which convert the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and release the oxygen, the process may be stopped. So this is one of the human interpretations or disturbed of the human activities. Look at that. More carbon moves into the atmosphere due to burning of fossil fuel and deforestations. Most of the carbon in atmosphere is in the form of the carbon dioxide. So when you look at the atmosphere, the carbon is present in the form of the carbon dioxide. We should know that the carbon dioxide have the more amount of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So this is the one we should know that. So carbon dioxide is the greenhouse gases. So one more question we ask, which is the greenhouse gases? It is nothing, carbon dioxide. By increasing the amount of the carbon dioxide on earth, or the earth becomes warmer. So if the carbon dioxide is increased in the atmosphere, what will happen? The earth become as a burning conditions. It means the temperature will be increased. If the temperature will be increased, means what will happen? So we all disturbed. So look at that. This leads to the greenhouse effect and global warming. So it will increase the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So it will lead the global warming. So global warming means, so it will disturb the nature, the entire ecosystem. So we should not follow the, or we should not see the proper season in a particular month. The plants may not survive because of the heat. So it is one of the important issues we have to keep in our mind. So we have to avoid burning of the coal, or we have to replace the plants where we destroy the plants. So look at this, this leads to the greenhouse effect and global warming. So we have to be controlled. If you are continually doing that, so the earth will be disturbed. So here, so look at this there. So once again, now you are more clear. While we are burning, So what will happen? Carbon dioxide deposit or release into the atmosphere. While the animals and plants are do the respirations, so carbon dioxide release to the atmosphere. So this is the arrow mark. So while the plants do the respirations. So this is the arrow mark. So during the photosynthesis, what will happen? The atmospheric carbohydrate intake and oxygen released. So after that, what will happen? The decay of the plants, it will produce carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. So once again, so sometimes plants and living organism goes death after move to the deep of the earth, so it become as a fossil fuel. So while we are burning the fossil fuel, so what happened? The carbon dioxide released. So this is the very simple explanations for the carbon cycle. So the carbon cycle, the carbon maybe is the form of the charcoal, diamond, graphites. So during the photosynthesis time, so the carbon is take oxygen release, or the carbon dioxide is intake and oxygen release. So after it moved to the herbivorous, then carnivorous. So carbon dioxide is also is returned to the atmosphere while the decomposition of the death organism. So in the form of the organic matters. So the organic matters is absorbed by the plants. Once again, it deposit to the atmosphere during the respiration of the plants. So burning of the fossil fuel also, it will release the carbon dioxide. So this is the things. So the simple explanations already I told that. So deforestations and burning of the fossil fuel, so we have to be careful on that. So we have to handle properly, which is a help for proper environment or proper ecosystem. So we can avoid the global warming. So this is the ones, it increase of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, it lead to the global warming and greenhouse effects. Thank you.